Hallo YouTubers, this is Bissell Stain Pro Carpet Cleaner. It suddenly stopped to work. I saw that the brush is not rotating. There's a panel, so you can check from this panel. You can open it very easy like this. Moving that way. The belt is broken. We need to change the belt. I found another problem, why the belt is gone. So this is what rotating the brushes, so it is very hard. So if you rotate your machine, you rotate it, it should move freely. So this one is very tight. To take the whole system out, there is two screws. One screw is here and the other one is here. You need to take out this bracket too, and there is a small brush here. The other one is broken, so I think it should be one here. I saw that in catalog they have one here, but I see that it's broken. There is some rust debris and other stuff on this shaft. You can clean it up with Dremel or sandpaper, whatever, to have a clean shaft before you install the new belt. I cleaned up the shaft as good as I could. Now we are going to check everything before we install the belts.
I feel the one is not pushed over.
So you can take this part out. I feel that the water pump is not moving freely. I'm gonna check it to be sure before I assemble the belts. Another problem I found. Here is your water goes through the water pump. There is too much air inside here. Two at the middle is long one, and two in front is a short one. Don't mix them up. Here's the water pump. So we're gonna check to be sure what's inside there, that the water pump don't run freely. It is very stuck. I cannot move it with my hand. Yeah, it is kind of stuck. It is not moving freely. Okay. We There's our water pump shaft. It is very hard to rotate because silicone don't damage plastics. So I would have silicone inside in this direction and the other direction and let it play a little bit to see it's freeing up or not. It is very tight. Yes, it's freeing up. It's coming out. This washer goes this way. Yeah. This part is kind of free after. Yeah, it is moving freely right now. After I put some silicone inside, I see there is a bearing inside. I would clean up this shaft too with rubbing alcohol or something. And after that, I would clean up inside here too. And then assemble it and check if it's running freely or not. I found some resist here inside this brass bushing. I tried to clean it, but still I feel some resist. It's not moving all freely. I cleaned this shaft with my Dremel tool, so what I do, I'm gonna use silicone grease. You can use every other greases. Let me grease it up and install this part again and see if it's moving freely or not. I used silicone grease for this part, as you can see. So it is moving very freely without any problem. So it is very nice and free. In the last step, you see some black shades here. I'm gonna clean it with park cleaner to don't have any resist. Problem actually was this part. Remember to put it on right way when you want to put it back. There is, see here, so we're gonna rotate this one that way. There we go. Here's a belt I purchased from Amazon. This is not the belt which as I purchased from B-Cell itself. I didn't find the belt to replace it. So we're gonna, here is the part number. And it came with two part belts inside. Two of your main belt and two water pump to the brush belts. Now we are installing our water lines. Before we are installing our water line, at this point we can put the belt on instead that we're working on that tight space. To put the belt on, you can put the belt through here, or if you're working from downside, you can put the belt from downside and through here. Okay, I put the belt on. Try to rotate it several times to see it's not falling out, it's not a problem, it's freely moving, everything is okay. No, I'm gonna put back these two water lines and put back the cover. Two long ones was for the middle. Next, there's two tabs here. Need to go inside there. The other belt we're gonna install, it goes here and it goes right here. Okay, everything is working. I hope you like this video. Thumbs up and subscribe.